topic is our food and its digestion. So in the previous class, we have learned about healthy eating habits and then cooking of food, importance of cooking food, precautions before our life, cooking we have learned. So let me continue the lesson here. So this is the last point of this lesson, that is food preservation, methods of preservation of food. And I simply see the food chart here, different foods you can see in the chart, isn't it, my children? So maybe your mouth is watering by seeing these foods, isn't it? So many of them would have eaten all these foods, I think so. So let me today explain about the food preservation and the methods of preservation of food. Children, if food is kept for a long time, what happens? It gets spoiled. Microorganisms act on this food and makes the food unfit for eating, isn't it? So the children, what we need to do? We need to preserve it. We need to preserve the food by not getting spoiled. So what we have to do? So to preserve the food, we need to follow a few methods there. So the method used to preserve the nutritional value for a long time is called food preservation. The method used to preserve the nutritional value of a food for a long time is called food preservation. Okay, if you preserve the food, there are few advantages. So we can use that food. So what are the advantages? It decreases the wastage of food. It decreases the wastage of food and also it increases the shelf life of food materials. Shelf life means what? The length of time for which a product or food can be kept. Okay, so it increases the shelf life of food materials. Preserved food is available out of season also. So preserved food can be used in out of season. Okay, when particular vegetable or particular thing is not getting, food is not available. So out of season also, if you preserve it, you can use it later. Okay, so next is methods of preservation of food. So cooked or uncooked food can be preserved by following these methods, like methods of preservation of food, by following these methods, even they have given. So, food can be preserved in different ways. So, first one is refrigeration. So, we will have a refrigerator at home, children. So, what your mother will do? She will keep foods like vegetables, fruits, milk, eggs, and all in the refrigerator. So, what happens there? If you keep it in the refrigerator, germs do not grow in low temperature. So that is the reason. So this is also one method. So this is one method that we can preserve the food. Foodstuffs like bread, eggs, milk, you can see the chart here, and then vegetables, fruits and all, you can preserve it in the refrigerator. Okay, so we can preserve it so that the germs will not grow in them. So that is one method. And then second one is canning. Some foodstuffs can be stored in airtight containers. Some foodstuffs can be stored in airtight containers. Bacteria and germs cannot grow in them as they do not get enough air and moisture there. So, if the foodstuff is stored in an airtight container, what happens? Bacteria and germs will not grow because they do not get air and moisture there. So, that is why some foods are available in the markets so that they can be eaten easily. Already it is cooked and it is stored in the airtight container. Just you have to bring it home and you can eat it. Just add water to that, hot water, and you can use it. In foreign countries, even in India, also so many foodstuffs are available. They are ready to eat like that. So these foods are canned. These foods are stored in the airtight container. Okay. And then even fruit juices and some sweets are canned for preservation. Okay. And the next is another method is boiling. So boiling at a very high temperature, what happens? It kills the germs. Boiling at very high temperature kills the germs. It helps in preserving liquid foods like milk. Okay. So the milk, after bringing the milk from shop, what you do, what your mother will do, she will boil the milk. Okay. So boiling at very high temperature kills the germs. So that is one method. Okay, next is drying. Some vegetables like carrot, peas, cauliflower are dried and preserved and are used in off season. Some vegetables like carrot, peas, cauliflower, some more are there. So they are dried and used in off season. Off season is when the few vegetables are not available in some season. So we can dry it, we can keep it, later we can use it. When those vegetables are not available in that season, we can use them after drying it. So what happens when the food is dried? Bacteria and other germs cannot grow. Air will not get moisture there. In this way, food can be saved from spoilage. In this way, foodstuff can be saved from spoilage. Okay, next is pickling. So you all know about pickles, isn't it? You've been having at home. So pickles, food can be stored by adding certain chemicals. Food can be stored by adding certain chemicals known as preservatives. A commonly known preservative is salt. The salt is the main thing for pickles, isn't it? Like a raw mango or lemon, your mother or your grandmother will prepare the children. So, more salt is added there. Why salt is added? And even oil and salt. Oil and salt, it acts like a preservative there. So, it does not allow the germs to grow in that. It preserves the food there. And then we use the for making pickles, many vegetables we use like cauliflower, raw mango, chilies, and then mixed vegetable pickles also we use. But the main thing, you need to add the preservative, that is salt. Salt and oil are added to preserve it. And as children, vinegar is also added, so it preserves the food, like it preserves the pickles from not getting the germs will not grow in them. So even vinegar is also used to preserve some pickles. And next is jams. Most of the fruits are made into jams by adding sugar. So excess sugar is also a good preservative like salt. Excess sugar if you are adding in jam, so we can preserve the food there. And then microbes cannot grow because of excess sugar in the jam. Microbes cannot grow in that. You can see the jam here. So many types of fruits are added to make the jam, and excess sugar is used. So it will preserve the food there. So these are the methods of preservation of food, children. I hope you have understood. And one activity they have given here. So that is activity 3. So how the food is they have to show the spoiling of food. They have shown in the picture here. So let me explain that one. So to show the spoiling of food, you can see that. I mean, you can do that at home also. Take 2 slices of bread. Keep 1 slice outside for 2-3 days and keep it moist. So what you have to do? Take 2 slices of bread. Keep 1 slice outside for 2-3 days and keep it moist. Keep other slice in the refrigerator. 1 slice you keep it outside and 1 slice you keep it in the refrigerator. Keep 1 slice outside for 2-3 days. Then what happens? Keep other slice in the refrigerator and the next point, observe after 2-3 days. Observe after 2-3 days. A brownish green layer is seen on the bread slice which was kept outside. You can see the greenish. You can see the in the picture, you can see here. A greenish, you can see, no children, something you can see on the bread here. So a brownish green layer is seen on the bread slice which was kept outside. It means it is spoiled and cannot be eaten. You can see the something is grown on the slice of bread which is kept outside, and the slice which was kept inside the bread will not get spoiled there. So the bread slice kept in the refrigerator does not get spoiled and can be eaten. So like this, you can do this activity at home. And then conclusion, air and moisture can spoil the food. So the conclusion is air and moisture can spoil the food if kept for a long time. So one slice was outside the fridge and one was inside the fridge, no, for 2-3 days. So the problem, you can see the something is grown on that bread slice, that is brownish green layer. So that is, it is not good for eating. Okay, like that we can do this activity. So let me end my class here. So I'll send the notes in the